Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an Rx3i input analog module. I have here an IC695ALG112. Okay. This is a 12 channel current or voltage input module. A couple things I wanted to tell you guys about this is there's 12 channels. They're located on both sides of this high density terminal. When you're probing, a very important thing to remember, when you're probing each channel, make sure that you have the wires on the correct, or your probes on the correct terminals. So each channel is comprised of three terminals. So the first channel is 1, 2, and 3. The nearest most two terminals from the common, the common's on number 3, or the third one down, or the sixth one down on the second channel, ninth one down on the third channel, and so on. The nearest most screw is for voltage. All right, bear that in mind, it's for voltage. And when you want to switch over, and we'll show you this on testing milliamps, or current in milliamps, then you're going to want to use the furthest most. So from the common, which is 3, it would be 1. From the common, which is 6, it would be 4, and so on. Okay. Now, once my terminal strip is fully attached by putting this lever into the upward most position, I'm going to get a green light showing me that my terminal block is now making connection to all the terminals on the module itself. I have a green blinking light on the module telling me that it's okay. It's gone through a self-diagnostic. So you want to make sure that, you know, you see green here. If you don't get any lights on at all, or if it's red, then that means that there's a problem with the module. You won't be able to follow this test, and it'll likely need repair or even replacement. Okay. So if you are powered up and it looks like what I have here, the next thing that you want to do, I'm going to be in Proficy Machine Edition as the software I'm using. So I'm going to go to my software package, go to rack 0. I have a blank file. I'm using slots 0 and 1 with my power supply and 2 and 3 with my CPU. That leaves the next available slot as slot number 4, which is what my module is in. I'm going to right click, or you can double click and add module, go to the analog input, and we're looking for IC695ALG112, 12 channel isolated analog input. We hit OK. Now the first thing is take a little bit of time. We're going to have to go through and we're going to have to enable each channel by clicking on where it says disabled and allowing it to select voltage or current. It's going to by default select negative 10 volt DC to positive 10 volt DC. So we'll go ahead and test DC first, for simplicity's sake. Now the other thing I'm doing is changing my channel value format to 16-bit integer for this test, which is plenty. All we want to do is make sure that each channel is working, that it's reading the voltage or the current that you're feeding it, and making sure that the channels are all stable. That's the basic test. Configuration is part of that test, which is what we're doing right now. Now, the scaling I'm also leaving as the default values, so you guys might want to keep that in mind. And as time-taking as it is, we have to do every single channel. All right, last channel. So the next thing is, as soon as I'm done with this, I want to hit the lightning bolt icon and connect up to the processor. We're going to start feeding it this information as soon as it's ready. Click the handprint. Now notice down below, if you follow my arrow here, I'm in programmer mode. It's stop faulted. Configuration is not equal, logic is equal. It's because the processor was doing a different task before we did this, even if it's a slightly different task. We're gonna go to target, online commands, and clear. We're gonna clear those faults, the controller and IO fault table only, leave everything else alone. And this will keep us from getting hung up. Now you can see down below it's switched to stop disabled, meaning that the inputs and outputs are disabled. Now we're ready to go to download. Okay, that's this download and start active target icon. The first thing it's going to ask us is what do we want to download to the controller. In this particular case, just for a simple test of the inputs, hardware configuration and logic. We're going to select OK. And this is going to go through a download build with the processor, downloading all that information. The information it's downloading, of course, is the settings that we have on the ALG112. While it's doing that, I want to let you guys know I'm using a 3-volt memory battery. Okay, it's about the size of a AA battery, but it's 3 volts, and I have 2 leads coming off of it, a positive and a negative. I'm going to be using those leads to probe these channels. I like to have a voltage that's not quite the very 10-volt limit. If you guys have a voltage generator that you guys can generate, from 0 to 10 volts or negative to a positive 10 volts, that's great too. This works for me. Okay, we're going to enable the outputs. Now, also notice on the settings that the reference address that we're going to be looking for these values on is analog input 00001. And in case, unless you guys change that for yourselves, but just make sure you know where your reference address is. So, as I said before, if you look at our settings, I'll show you channel 1. We're good from negative 10 to positive 10 volts, hence the reason we see negative 10,500 as our starting value. Now, when I probe with positive 3 volts, I should have somewhere, so I have a value of 3,036. All right, again, I'm using 3 volts. That was terminals 2 and 3, now I'm going to go to, if I can get my probes on there, 5 and 6, 8 and 9, 11 and 12, 14 and 15. Now, if you're watching on the screen itself, you see that my values are stable. They're stable at the 3,041 mark. Okay, and that's what you want to see, 17 and 18. And so on. Now you would carry this test through the rest of the terminals on the other side, of course, 20 and 21 and so forth, all the way down through channels channel 12, which is located on 35 and 36. All right, so we're going to go back to the ALG. We're going to stop the controller, starting with our channel 1. We're going to drop this down to 4 to 20 milliamp, or you guys can use 0 to 20 milliamp, doesn't really matter, as long as we're checking for current measured in milliamp. And we're able to verify that those channels work. Okay, channel 9. And of course, we're going to have to re-download this. We're asking it to do something slightly different, so we will have to also clear the fault tables. So we're going to ask it to, we're going to clear our fault tables first. If you look down below, we're stopped, disabled, but our configuration is not equal. What we're asking it to do is slightly different than what we did before. Go to target, online commands, clear controller fault and IO fault table, okay. Yep. Download and run. Same thing as the first time. We're going to be downloading configuration, motion, and logic. Since this is just a test, we don't really want to write anything to permanent flash memory or anything like that. We're just validating that this analog input is working properly, so we select OK. Now, in the background, something that you guys are not able to see is that I'm using a 4 to 20 milliamp generator, okay? You guys may have something similar in the field, but you will need some sort of something that generates current in milliamp in order to be measured. What I want to let you guys know is that the unit that I'm using is adjustable. I can go all the way from 4 to 20 milliamps, just like it says. But the reason that's important is because typically what I see, not every time, but when a channel fails, it fails at full value. So it'll fail depending on what your settings or your scaling is. You know, it'll fail at 20,000, or if your settings are 32,767, it'll fail at 32,767. And what that means is that whether I try to dial it down from 20 to maybe 18 or 17 or 13 milliamps, it's consistently reading at the full value. It won't budge, it won't move, even if I go up and down. So you need to test for that. All right, so I'm going to show you what I mean. Physically, Because if you look at the channels right now, starting with channel 1, again, I'm going to be probing terminals 1 and 3. Now, I have a value of very, very close to 20,000, 19,939.40. It's consistent, it's stable, it's not moving around erratically. Now I'm going to dial down, okay? So the value is going to get lower and lower and lower. We're going to hit 12, 11, 10, and I'm going to go back up. Okay, so now I know that that particular channel has good range and resolution. It's able to detect that the values are going up and down. Okay, same thing once I make a connection, pardon me, on channel 2. That's 6 and 4 are the terminals. Then I'm going to go down and back up. Okay, so you want to do this with every channel. You want to make sure that you got a good range and resolution. You want to make sure that your channels are solid and stable, that there's not a lot of movement, and that would be a good indication that each channel is working. So, if you follow this test as far as I've showed you, and you check all your channels, and they're all both stable and have range and resolution, then I would say it's a very good working unit. If at the beginning of this video you're not able to get a module OK light on, and you're unable to follow this test, you'll need replacement or repair. If any of the channels are unstable, if they fluctuate greatly, if they fail at full value the way I described, any of those things, you have a analog input card that needs repair or replacement. So we do repair these ALG112s here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you guys need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.